I think one thing which we came here was that there was, first of all, there is lack of representation of Indian youth in any of the UNFCCC or any of the international negotiation processes, including what we have in CBD. Interestingly, the government of India actually prepared a delegation of youth, which just included people from the coastal and marine areas around the coast or areas of island states. So that was something which was a little hitting. It was something which we didn't excited us to be a part of it in the first place. So we decided, let's have a delegation which goes to COP, which also talks to the people who are working on different issues and also look at how negotiation as a process happens. So it is not only about the people who are living on the coast, it is also about people who are generally living in the new urban ecosystem and people who are living in the diverse ecosystem zones of the country. So that was one of the pinching reason to come here. Yeah.
In the name of your organization, the keyword is youths and climate, of course. There has been this undercurrent in COP11 this year that there has not been enough youths representation, given the fact that youth is a very critical stakeholder in the space of biodiversity and climate. So what are your comments on it?
I think one thing which we have to know is that these international negotiations actually represent a framework with what is happening at the local level. So we already are lacking a whole process of youth participation from local level to the national level. So if you look at the whole of the legislations, whether they are coming, there is even youth affairs legislation don't include the people who are actually stakeholders. So that's something which is really annoying in the whole system. So when you get to the international level, it is also representing the same system. So it is manifesting what is happening in the countries.
So youth may be a stakeholder, but since you interact with youth a lot, you're a campaigner, do you think that there's a reason why youth is not taken seriously in matter like decision making and policy making?
One thing which I have to say that recently they have started doing it. So it is not a doomsday scenario. So there is a representation of youth which is coming. So inclusion of the idea of coastal and marine communities in the first place coming from the government of India is something really exciting on one front, whether it is an exclusive idea to go for. Second thing, if you look at the negotiation itself, this whole global youth for biodiversity network created under the framework of CBD is something, another initiative which is happening, but their voices now need to get to another level. So their voices are, they are bringing people together, but their voices are yet to reach a level where the negotiators are. We are already having, I'm sorry to use the word fussy, but the processes which happen at international level are a little fussy for an individual layman who is out there, who is youngster, who has a lot of energy. So first of all, these processes bring the energy down. So, but there is also, and on different levels, there is also engagement which is happening by the governments, whether it is an inclusion of one paragraph in a particular statement or coming up with the Youth and Children Day, a youth and children mechanism in UN processes, in different UN processes, who are also vulnerable to different environmental disasters. So that is, there are both ways, if I say. There is one process which is slowly moving, but it is moving too slow to get into it.
You said that at a level like this meeting, youth representation will come if there's local representation, if there's local or regional inclusion of youths. Thoughts and ideas. What is your organization doing to organize the youth energy and youth thoughts?
So first of all, whenever these processes are happening, one we are tracking and sharing it in a very simple language with the people. So we organize small events. One of them was deformalizing the BioD conference for people who are just around to understand what is happening, because the terms and conditions and references are too strong for a simple person to understand. Second thing, we are also trying these processes to go in the native languages. So we are trying our best to get, I'm personally translating some of the websites of international organizations to get that stuff, whatever is happening, to the people who can access internet in the first place. And second way is to go to the pamphlets. Second process which we are doing is the participation of youth at international forums, which is the representation. IYCN has an accreditation status with the UN, and we are sending youth delegation from last 3 to 4 years. And we also have people who are working in different domains, who are exposed, whether it was conservation, whether it was policy making, whether it was just a person who is working and doing small things at his home and in his community. community. So we had the largest delegation to Copenhagen. After that, we also had a delegation to Cancun and different other places wherever the processes are, international processes on environment and climate change are happening.